as the ladies are up in their seats and salute, green and racing to the bottom of turn one.
The ladies are up in their seats. Tommy Pools is up on the wheel as he is trying to pull off the 96 of Kurt Greener. And Greener has handled the numbers beautifully.
For second is a battle between Bulls on the inside, the color red. Todd Owen is right there in the mix with car number 81. And he moving to the front of the class to meet Big Cat. Big Cat, the defending series champion. He's on the podium in the third spot. Season 3 on the bottom. Big Cat and Foster are in the wheel. And the meat and the sandwich there is Tommy Bulls.
And it's Ronnie Williams who is able to whisk his way into second. So the rookie, car number 59. Jump on Bulls. And I'm making a move down low is Todd Owen. As Todd Owen trying to climb the 25 car on Sean Foster. The lead is just
pulled. He has definitely come into the front zone of cars. As now Foster sees a little daylight. As all of a sudden Bulls becomes the emblem point in this one. Meanwhile, Todd Owen doesn't give up on the bottom. Doug Cody is there as a factor. Is off the pace to the bottom. He loses 2, 3, make it 4 positions there, Matt.
He almost wound up in lawnmower country out on the grass. Now Kobe gets by him on the outside. Jarvis is right behind him. At the front of the field is Greener. Here comes Ronnie Williams trying to get to the lead for the first time in his escape out of 5 career. He is giving it everything he has as they come out of the fourth quarter.
Off the turn, they rumble down to the line, and it is a good battle going on at the takes over the lead, starts to pull away, and Williams has now become the top dog in this feature event. Further back in the competition, here comes Keith Rocco. He's threading the needle rather nicely, working his way through traffic as well.
Danny makes a double against the 25 of Sean Foster, and then Mark Foster is able to hold him over.
Setting
having such tremendous success in all the other divisions he's competed in.
Yeah, 8 wins in the dirt modifies this year, but it looks like he runs into a big problem of lap number 15. What a big, frantic pace in this one. Of course, Ronnie Williams, a rookie, is going against the best.
Potter Sullivan is down on a pit road where a lot of cars are already in, including Ryan Sullivan, Cipriano, Membrino, and Mueller.
Well, down here in the 84 pit of Joey Cipriano, they had a lot of trouble with this car in practice, trying to get the rear end adjusted just so. They're checking the air pressure in the left rear tire. They put out Jackson's, but they're going decided to let him go. Let's go down to Tony Sutton.
Eric Burt, the hood is off the car. It appears he's the plug wires have popped off because the car's got a really bad skip. They're checking them each at a time now. And I'll tell you what, that's got to be tough stuff because those exhaust pipes are right over top of the plugs. It's now having a little trouble getting the hood back on. Brainerd sitting anxiously in his number 66, waiting for the crew to get the hood back on the car back upstairs.
Well, that's kind of a heartbreaker for him. Eric Burns is a real good race car driver. Nice guy, family guy, as the field goes back to green. Guys that get stuck on that one included Brian Sullivan, Manfredo, and Mueller, because they are way back from the competition here. They can go on the field. Jack Rock, Keith Rocco, we haven't seen anyone like this in quite a while. Off turn number 4, Jack Rock is wheel to wheel with the number 59 machine. Ronnie Williams, Williams guards the inside lane to the outside.
Trying to move in against Brainerd. That's Michael
appearance here.
And Woody Pitcat, also struggling tonight, started out running very strong at the beginning of this event, and all of a sudden he's off the pace. Remember a year ago when Woody Pitcat was driving for the Greer Motorsports Group, he started the season tough, but by the midpoint, he started to show a lot of improvement and a lot of success, and they're hoping that that same formula is going to come to play here in the Scavaro-owned race car. Let's go down to Tony Sutton.
They made an air pressure adjustment on the 50 car, Woody Pitcat. They've got a rubber they're going to put in, but now, after consultation with the driver and the crew chief, they've decided not to put the rubber in the rear. The 13 board is out. Ted Christopher coming back in. Christopher in the 13 in his fifth. They go to work in the check underneath. They're checking the stagger on the tires right now, making sure that this car is going to handle properly. No, they are making an adjustment on the rear suspension on the number 13 car. Ted Christopher sits anxiously in the car. Now they're going to check the air pressure from right and left on the number 13 car, and it's valuable time that's going by for Ted Christopher, who has to jump back on an airplane and fly back to Loudon after this event. Back upstairs.
Well, he definitely is not happy with that race car at this point in the event. Incidentally, Christopher is running a red 13 car at New Hampshire International Speedway as well. And also down at Pit Road, Todd Owen is there. They struggled. They had a problem with the carburetor and took the motor out of that race car this past week, sent it back to Pettit, ran it on the dyno, trying to figure it out. It did find some things wrong with it. But now that car, they've adjusted the stagger on the rear of that as well. Bowles has been in and out of Pit Road. And yes, Teddy Christopher does make it back. And if you know Teddy Christopher, there's 20 laps for him to get back to the front of the field. Roy Talman is also down on Pit Road as well, and he looks to rejoin in the competition here.
Some determination for the driver, car number 33, as he comes back, and we are getting ready for a restart. Dan Avery in his 50s against Kid Rock as they swirl their way off the corner. Let's see what kind of restart Keith Rocco was able to get. He had a blockbuster one the last time.
Well, this one looks just as good. Freeze stays glued to the back of Avery. Avery now pulls it back in the second. Sean Foster, what a great run for him.
He has run that move in the outside, getting the best of Doug Colby as he drives him off the car. Right after he's trying to take off Ronnie Williams. There's that heavy dose of Priest's lightning. But Ronnie Williams holds him off as he exits the corner.
There was almost a little bit of touchy feeling going on there as they came together just for a moment. Here comes Foster now to the outside of Priest again. Shakers. Ryan Sullivan is coming from way in the back of the pack. He's now contending at the bottom of the top 10. Off the turn, they rumble to the line. Now here comes Doug Colby working his magic to the outside of Sean Foster. That's the guy. Position number 5, Bobby Foster runs a 6 meter in 7 spot. 22, and I believe that the car that brings out the caution is the 33 of Troy Talman. Did not make heavy contact with the wall, but that's too late. So he has gained a lot of ground. Todd Bowen is back down on pit road. That car is not working as well as they anticipated. So we've got 29 of 42. Let's set the field. Keith Rocco, your leader. Dan Avery in a torrid battle between him and Ronnie Williams in third. Ryan Preece in fourth. Doug Colby's got five. Great run for Foster in sixth. Kurt Brainerd for seventh. Chase Dowling for eighth. Ryan Sullivan for ninth. And Matt Galco to round out the top 10 Matt.
And one thing about Kurt Brainerd, he is seventh. He has not finished in the top 10 all year. So this could be his best outing of the season. 13 laps to go. And getting the jump as he usually does is Keith Rocco.
So quick on the start. He's like a rabbit just jumping out of a hole, being chased by the dogs. Off the second turn, he looks pretty well. He's just one simple mistake. If he can find an opening, he's going to be all over the front two. Meanwhile, Doug Colby's been up and down tonight, and he is still there fighting. And Williams just doesn't want to be left out of this one. What a great run for the young Titans.
Intense at the front. Keith Rocco leading by a few down.
most consistent guys, it seems, they never have a bad restart.
That is so true. You have to give a shout-out to Chase Dowling. Now, we talked about it before. A lot of people compare Chase Dowling with Ryan Preece. He's the next up-and-coming superstar. Look at the records this season. Ryan Preece was the dominant car in the SK Modifieds. This kid came out of nowhere. Chase Dowling, and he bumped him out of the winner's circle, took over the number one spot, youngest driver in the history of Stafford's SKs to do that, and the kid is all over Ryan Preece right now. So that's a name to put into your record books. It's a name that you're going to be hearing a lot about. There's no question there. With 41 up on the board, here's Matt Buckler. We are going to a green line checker situation. If you think it's over with, you are wrong.
Here comes Rocco, car number 88, like soda out of the shaking can. Rocco is back in front. Williams swinging into the outside.
Strong in the competition here, Matt Galco.
Eddie Ice just suffered a meltdown underneath the sprint sign.
So
we go into double overtime.
We sure do. As that car, we can see from our vantage point that it looks like some damage done to the front end of the race car. That's going to change the whole complexion of this one. Dan Avery has worked the outside groove the entire first 41 laps. And never made a bid on the bottom, but on that last restart, put the car to the inside, and it works there just about as well as it works in the outside lane. So Williams is going to have his hands full on this restart. Doug Covey, that's the best we've seen the 15 run in quite some time. And then, of course, that battle with Chase Dowling and Ryan Preece and Sean Foster, who's hung there with the big dogs. Nice to see that car really coming into...
Two restarts that we've had right now, just a big, big reaction negatively from this 88 crew. They want this win bad here for Heat Rocco.
Well, we're about ready to go back to green. Last chance, tweet the winner. Who is it going to be? Last opportunity to tweet us and tell us who you think is going to win this SK Modified main event. As they head off turn number four, Tim Bennett staring them down. Keith Rocco, Ronnie Williams.
Well, Ronnie Williams, that's
not in trouble. Right in trouble. What a massive melee. We've got Keith Rocco, literally up on top, and we've got a scramble of cars. Doug Colby's car has come to a screeching halt. And wow. The calm before the storm becomes the storm itself.
The top two are involved.
That's
Rocco and Ronnie Williams.
And Keith Rocco, who was so awesome. And the same can be said about Williams, as those two cars tangled down the front straightaway. We literally saw Rocco's car up and almost going over.
I don't know if he came up to speed on this restart.
Have to take a look and see what we can find out. But what a heartbreaking situation for the two cars, Heath Rocco and Ronnie Williams.
32 years later, he has a reflexes to avoid what could have been a massive setback for him.
Certainly is going to be a great race right to the finish. 41 laps up on the board, lights are off on the safety vehicle. Last chance to tweet us your winner. It all can change in the blink of an eye. Keep your eyes on not only the front row, but all the rows back to the bottom of the top 10. You see Ted Christopher is now emerging among the top cars as well. So let's see what's going to happen. Here's Matt Buckler as we're about to go back to green.
Dan Avery on the inside, being challenged by Doug Covey. Very gingerly coming off the corner. Now they pick up the momentum. Covey, good job on the outside. Let's see if Avery can beat him into the second corner. Dan
wide. Here comes Doug Colby, gripping in. Colby up on the outside of Avery. Avery just refuses to be left out of this one. They come together. Doug Colby goes around. Avery stops on the racetrack. And Chase Dowling is caught in the line of fire. They come off turn number four. What's going to happen now? Ladies and gentlemen, yellow checker comes out. Ryan Preece will take down the win. Teddy Christopher in an unbelievable finish will finish in second. Sean Foster will finish on the podium in the third spot. And amazingly, Woody Pitcast to finish in fourth with unofficially given the white flag. That means the lap had to be finished, and it was. And when all the dust cleared, it was car number two, Ryan Preece, back in winning form. And guess what? The last time we were here, it was 13-2. This time, it's 2-13. And if you think this is good, wait till, not next week, but the week after, $5,000 is on the line. You think they raced hard tonight?
Well, when we next see Ryan Preece tomorrow, he'll be on national TV, on ESPN2, competing in the Nationwide Series race. But we saw something tonight that we have not seen, I don't know if ever. First, it looked like the race was going to be decided between Keith Rocco and Ronnie Williams. They got involved in an altercation. Another green-white checker, it looked like it was going to be decided between Dan Avery and Doug Colby. One lap to go, Doug Colby took the lead on the outside. Then Dan Avery tried to get the lead back coming out of turn number one. Those two cars got together, and Ryan Preece was able to avoid the wreckage and was able to get the win.
And then poor Chase Dowling, who turned the run of his career, he actually went around Preece to manage to take over a front position as well. But then, unfortunately, he got caught in the melee. Now to Napa Victory Lane before the fireworks.
Well, Ryan Preece, how many times in those last few seconds did you go, what the? What is happening here?
Sometimes you're better to be lucky than good, and everything just kind of fell our way there at the end, and we're just trying to get through the way we have to run tires. We had to run our old tires on this race, and I mean, Keith had a really good car, and so did the 59 and Doug and Dan, but sometimes it's better to be patient and kind of see how it plays out. But I got to thank my sponsors, Mitzi Construction, Sullivan & Sons. We have 10 more seats available, everybody, for the bus to go to New Hampshire tomorrow. So be sure. I'll post up a phone number so you guys can get tickets. J&A Auto, Gunsmoke Stables, Pettit Racing Engines, Napa of Canton. We have to thank Napa. All you fans for coming out. Enjoy the fireworks. And everybody else in this car, FK Ronan, Sean Wendell Communications, CD Chassis, Racing Electronics. It's a good way to start my weekend.
Ryan Preece, that was amazing. I mean, you guys are running really hard. You moved up through the field very well. Well-deserved win, but it came at the cost of some other guys. But obviously, you can't run two cars in the space of one.
Yeah, and like I said, sometimes I hate it for those guys because I've been in this situation, and it's rough. But, you know, we fought for this one. We earned it, but, you know, we'll come back next week stronger.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Well, we're looking for the elusive Ted Christopher. You were pretty far back in the beginning there. Could you see what was going on car-wise way up front?
Yeah, I was like 13th on a green white check in the first one, so I had to take a second out of that. It wasn't bad. Actually, Ryan was real vulnerable, but it's going to get almost got beat up left.
Well, I'll tell you what, I know you were struggling with the car earlier on. A lot of adjustments have been made to the car. You weren't happy with the way it was handling. But obviously, being in the right place at the right time tonight is what it was all about.
Sometimes that's how it goes. Thank you.
Well, Ted, thank you very much. Congratulations on second. Good luck tomorrow. Well, race car. Third place podium, dude, from back of the pack.
Yeah, it's been a while. We've been hard at work with this car. It's a brand new car. We only have four races on it, so I'm hoping this is going to be a cycle of things to come. But third place, we're really happy to be here. Quick thank you to the Hinsdale of Ellington, Clearview, and TSI Harley Davidson, and we get a Napa hat finally because we have Napa talent on the car. And it's cool. to be here. I was hoping like hell these two would wreck in front of me, but I guess I was lucky enough to get in third. So we're on a roll of good things to come, I think.
Well, Sean, one thing that was very evident, a lot of matched cars and a lot of matched drivers as far as ability is concerned, and you're in that group, so congratulations on third place.
Thank you. Yeah, it's kind of weird because the car was a little tight during the race, and I came on the radio. I said, it's not even that bad. These guys are just really hooked up. So they're really hooked up. One more week, I think we're going to be right there to be able to battle for a win and not, you know, fifth or sixth or something. And be a couple lucky third, maybe we'll get a lucky win.
Friday night, do it again. Well, that wraps it up from down here. To say this was a